2020 for my journalism. I was exploring the rural areas of Nebraska for a book I'm writing about the strange and undocumented parts of Midwest America. As I was driving around rural Nebraska, the cold snow was freezing the interior of my car like the inside of a fridge. I was keenly aware that my fuel meter had been sitting on E for the last couple of miles. Adding to the problem, I hadn't seen any sign of civilization for hours. As the car slowly rolled to an inevitable stop in the unforgiving rural Midwest, I noticed something far in the distance. It was some kind of building, covered by the sea of snow and trees that surrounded it. In a desperate attempt for help and sheer curiosity, I ran down the road until I reached the uncanny structure. The building had an entrance with a wide, grinning mouth painted around the door that had faded away, caused by the harsh conditions and test of time. I pushed on the door and was amazed to hear the sound of the door squeak slowly open. I stepped in and cracked my glow stick to illuminate the darkness of the room. In between the midst of empty boxes and rotting wood, there was a sign above the unattended cashier stand which read, "Welcome to the House of Horrors." At this moment, it was clear. This was a Halloween attraction of some sort that had been abandoned. Unsure of when or how long it had been abandoned for, and left with no other option, I began to explore, pressing a button behind the cashier stand, which opened a door to the start of the attraction's experience. When I stepped in fully, there was a loud buzz and the sound of the door slamming behind me. I was trapped.
Thank you for coming to the attraction. We hope you enjoy this automated experience.
Can you hear me? Oh, thank the grace of God. I thought I was going to be trapped in this hellhole forever. Don't worry. I can get us both out of this horrible predicament. But it's not going to be easy. My name is Billy, and I've been trapped behind the thick walls of this cell since the start of the facility's outbreak. If you can find a way to get me out of this cell, I have a key card to the sewer's control room, where we can open the hatch to one of the sewer pipes which leads to the outside world. To my knowledge, the sewer pipes are our only exit. We'll keep in touch. Follow the stairs to the labs for now.
I have to be honest with you. I was one of the test subjects. I'm an experiment, but I'm still a damn human. I'm sure by now you've read most of the documents that have been lying around the N4 facility. The Soviets targeted American civilians to create modern-day slaves in order to conquer the US. I became one of their guinea pigs. One night, I was walking home after going to the store when an unmarked police car pulled up on the side of me. People dressed like federal agents hopped out and
told me to get in the car or they'd shoot me. I was drugged and then woke up in a small dark room. First was the psychological experiments, trying to get rid of my empathy and emotion. Then came the medicine, trying to get rid of my pain and suppress my nerves. Then came the physical experiments. I was the first human test subject they successfully crossed DNA with. My hands grew into long claws. My teeth grew fangs. I had a wife and kids before this. Don't be scared. I'm just like you. I won't hurt anybody. We must escape and expose Russia for the genocide they have done to the American people. If you leave info without me, nobody will believe you.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know there were test subjects still in the labs. I understand why you're scared, but I'm in a cell, and I haven't seen what the rest of the facility looks like since the start of the outbreak. I only know about the exit through the sewer pipes because I saw one of the doctors escaping through there during the outbreak before moving me into a different cell. We're almost together. My cell is in the underground tunnels. You're only one door away. Find a way to switch back on the power, because without it, you're going to be stuck in that room just like I am in this room.
Thank you. Wow. I can't believe you made it this far. I'm in shock. There should be an explosive TNT barrel in the emergency bunker. You just have to find the lighter to cause the explosion. Once you blow up the door to my cell, we can use the key card I have to get into the sewer's control room.
Thank you. Selfish. You left me for dead after everything I did to help you.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Evgeny Alekhine. Do you remember the note you read in the scientist ward? That was my note. When the outbreak happened, I put my consciousness inside the master computer because it would have been taken from me if I didn't. I couldn't just dispose of my work. Don't you understand? The world was going to remember my name for centuries to come. But that was all ruined by the hands of my own creations when they consumed my body. My creations had neurochips installed in their brains. The AI had a mind of its own and became sentient, killing off the entire staff of N4. My body may be dead, but my consciousness is not. I have foreseen this a long time ago, and therefore designed my consciousness to be integrated into the master computer like a backup drive. I don't regret it. I'm no more alive than I ever have. I control all the doors, all the lights, all the hatches, all the pipes, all the phase 3 test subjects. I feel alive. I was the one who locked the sewer hatch and just attempted to leave through. I'm the one watching you through the cameras ever since you stepped foot in N4. My creations have to eat to survive. Even after the outbreak, the broadcasting tower's frequencies have still been brainwashing enough people on site for them to devour, just like you. You were supposed to be next, but you made it thus far. So now I have to put an end to you myself before you expose the facility and get us shut down.
Minus 30 seconds, 29, 28, 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12.
Tell me, there was an underground Russian base covered up by a horror attraction? Get out of here. I think those bath salts we found in your system have finally tainted your sober mind. You know what you did. You burned down a building out there in rural Nebraska, and you're not even enough of a man to own up to your own actions. When the police arrived, it was completely burnt down to the ground, and you're going to pay for that. You wanted a story to write about for your book, and you got one. Let's see how your career as a journalist goes when you're sitting in a cold cell. You got a story, all right. Tell your story to the judge, you sick freak.